You're familiar with the trend of calling cognitive decline, especially Alzheimer's, type 3 diabetes, right? If not, you should listen to this video. And even if you are, you might pick up a couple of things. So let me just cover a couple of things really quickly. You know Dale Bredesen in his book, The End of Alzheimer's, he talks about a lot of different complicated things, 36 holes in the roof causing this problem. And so I attended his first training session for doctors, and he came up after the training session and asked me what I thought. And I said, I'm a little bit surprised. There was very little information on insulin resistance, and that's at least half the cause of cognitive decline, right? He looked at me kind of funny and he said, well, I think it's 100% the cause of Alzheimer's. 80% are known. The other percent, the rest of them, the following 20% are what we call CNS insulin resistance. Now, what he was referring to is that there's actually a concept, and there's science behind it showing that you can have a form of insulin resistance behind the brain, blood-brain barrier in the CNS, central nervous system. Now, my view when I was hearing about that and when I've talked about that before is that I think most of these people that have what's called CNS IR, you know, they use the most common ways of measuring corporeal or regular body IR, insulin resistance, and that is fasting blood glucose and a hemoglobin A1C. As we know, that's going to miss a huge number of people that have IR, insulin resistance, prediabetes. So there's quite a few dots to connect here. And again, as often happens when there's so many dots to connect, they're not all fully understood. Number one, there's clearly a link between insulin resistance and dementia. 80% of folks with Alzheimer's dementia have known insulin resistance or type 2 diabetes. Of those that don't, there's clearly evidence within their brain that they have insulin resistance. And again, my perspective is in that 20%, they just missed the rest of the insulin resistance. Now, there's something else you need to note, though. Insulin has a separate function within the brain regarding memory. And that may actually be one of the mechanisms that we don't talk a whole lot about. So they've done this. They've taken insulin and sprayed it up into the nose. That allows, the nose is an area where there's just a very little tissue between the nose and the inside the blood-brain barrier. Insulin can actually go through that membrane. What happens is there are several impacts of that insulin, many revolving around memory. Insulin has a separate, what we call pleiotropic or different type of role inside the brain that's focused on developing memory. And in fact, there are several different areas within the brain that you have this impact. One of the key ones, obviously, being the hippocampus. The hippocampus is an area where it truly connects the dots within the brain. And in a person with Alzheimer's dementia, sure enough, we will see significant decrease in the mass of the hippocampus. Nature magazine, you can't get any better than that in terms of hard science. They have a trend of labeling Alzheimer's as type 3 diabetes. Now, this gets into a bunch of protein markers associated, creating and documenting this association between insulin resistance and diabetes. I'm not going to go there. That would get too geeky. You know that I tend to get geeky and enjoy that, but I'm not going to do that in this video. I just wanted to make the point that if you haven't heard of the link between insulin resistance and Alzheimer's, you should be thinking about it. Thank you for your interest.
My name is Ford Brewer. I started off as an ER doc, became very frustrated with the fact that most things that bring people into the ER were preventable, like heart attack and stroke. I went to Johns Hopkins to get training and ended up running the program there in prevention. There I trained dozens of docs, and again, that was 3 decades ago. Since then, I've trained thousands of docs, and even more importantly, supervised those docs, and even most importantly, helped thousands of patients prevent things like heart attack and stroke. Waiting for the disease and hoping for a cure for this kind of devastation doesn't work. So come to Louisville, November 8th and 9th. We have a boot camp type of environment for 2 days where you learn all the things that you didn't learn from your doc in terms of heart attack, stroke prevention, things like cardiovascular inflammation, how to detect it, how to measure it, things like insulin resistance, the number one cause of inflammation, how to detect it, how to measure it, how to stop it, how to manage it. You also get, you can get the labs there for that event if you'd like and get a complete evaluation. In addition, you get an arterial scan called a CIMT. To get the right one of those is fairly difficult. So I'm looking forward to seeing you there. Thanks.